Dear friends, we are going to episode number 10. Now, episode number 10 relates to mode of execution. The relevant provisions are Order 21, Rules 30 to 36. When you come to Rule 30, you can see the heading, mode of execution. This is to be read along with section 51, which we have already referred to. Now let us see Rule 30 that relates to decree for payment of money. Every decree for which we have already dealt with, along with Rule 30 and Rule 21, simultaneous execution. But again, we will consider it. Every decree for payment of money, including a decree for payment of money as an alternative to some other relief, may be executed by the detention civil prison of the judgmentor, or by attachment and sale of his property, or by both. This is a power vested in the court, a mode of execution. A decree for payment of money can be executed by arresting the person, judgmentor, and detaining him in prison as per the provisions which we have already dealt with. Or by attachment and sale of immoral property, or both. Attachment and sale we will deal with separately. That is a vast subject. How attachment is to be made, how sale is to be effected, all these things in the coming episodes we will deal with. Then decree for 31, decree for specific movable property, which provides where the decree is for specific, any specific movable, or for any share in a specific movable, it may be executed by the seizure, if practicable, of the movable or share, and by delivery thereof to the party to whom it has been adjudged, or to such person as he appoints to receive delivery on his behalf, or by the detention civil prison of the judgmentor, or by attachment of his property, or by both. Specific movable property. An item of movable property is there which came into the possession of the defendant. Defendant is not returning. The plaintiff sued for return of that. A decree was passed. How it is to be effected? Delivery is to be effected by seizing that specific movable property. Money does not come under this. Money is not a specific movable property. Suppose a person has taken money from the plaintiff's pocket and it is not being returned. Decree for payment of money, that exact currency notes need not be delivered. Only money is to be realized. On the other hand, a very valuable thing. See, I am having Revue or Mass painting in my possession. That was taken by my friend when I am not in the house. In spite of request, he does not return. I am sure that he is not going to return. I file a suit. Suit is decreed. How that painting is to be delivered? Another painting or another photograph is not enough. The very item of movable property is to be delivered by actual seizure of that movable and production before court, and that will be handed over, delivered. And it is not possible then by the detention and civil prison of the judgment debtor, or by the attachment of his property, or both. That is a process to compel the obedience of the decree. Suppose the mobile is lost, and then in the coming sub rule 2 and 3, we will see, where any attachment under sub rule 1 has remained in force for 3 months. Originally it was for 6 months, it was amended in 1976 and reduced to 3 months. Where any attachment has remained in force for 3 months, and if the judgmentor has not obeyed the decree, and the decree holder has applied to have the attached property sold, such property may be sold. So, a specific mobile property is to be delivered to me. It is not being delivered. Actual seizure is not possible. It is not seen. The judgmentor has screened off the property, mobile property, or destroyed it. The decree cannot be executed. Then what is to be done? And in cases where any amount has been fixed by the decree to be paid as an alternative to delivery of mobile property, such amount, what is attached property may be sold, and out of the proceeds, I am reading sub-rule 2 of rule 31, and out of the proceeds, the court may award to the decree holder in case where any amount has been fixed by the decree to be paid as an alternative to delivery of mobile property, such amount, and in other cases, such compensation as it thinks fit, and shall pay the balance, if any, to the judgmentor on his application. So, an item of immobile property belonging to the judgmentor is attached, and at the end of the period of 3 months, till then it is not obeyed, decree is not obeyed, the attached property may be sold. For realization of what? If the decree provides for an alternative relief to the decree holder, that in case actual seizure and delivery is not possible, the decree holder will be entitled to rupees 1 lakh as compensation, if the decree provides so, by the attachment and sale of the immovable property belonging to the judgmentor, that 1 lakh can be realized. Suppose the property is sold for 1.5 lakhs. 1 lakh will be paid to the decree holder, and the balance 50,000 will be returned to the judgmentor whose property was sold. If by the sale of that particular item, the property, the amount is not realized, it is again, can be by some other property, it can be realized. And in other cases, such compensation. Decree does not provide the alternative relief. So the court will consider the question of compensation and fix a reasonable compensation. And out of the sale proceeds of the immovable property belonging to the judgmentor, such compensation will be paid to the decree holder. Sub-rule 3, where the judgmentor has obeyed the decree and paid all the costs of executing the same, which he is bound to pay, or where at the end of 3 months from the date of attachment, no application to have the property sold has been made, or if made, has been refused, the attachment shall cease. Suppose the decree is obeyed, and before the end of 3 months, immovable property which is to be specifically delivered has been delivered, the decree is obeyed, then the attachment will cease. Or if no application has been made by the decree holder to sell that property, then also the attachment shall cease. The court may, on the application, extend the period of 3 months mentioned sub-rule 2 then 3 to such period not exceeding 6 months. Let us wait for another 3 months, that let the attachment continue, the court may permit it, depending on the facts and circumstances of each case. It is a discretion of the court to allow it or not to allow it. Facts of each case will depend, the result will depend on the facts and circumstances of each case. Now we will go to Rule 32. Decree for specific performance or restitution of conjugal rights or for an injunction. Three types of decrees are referred to in Rule 32. Decree for specific performance, decree for restitution of conjugal rights, or for decree for injunction. Let us see sub-rule 1. Dear friends, why I am reading the rule is that let us have the very same words as used by the legislature, parliament. If we substitute it with some other words, the meaning may be different. So whenever we interpret something, first we have to see the statute, the provision, the relevant provision, then read it. Otherwise somebody may think, why should this person read all these things and then explain? It is for the effective exercise. Otherwise I substitute my words, that will not be fully correct. So we need not substitute the words used by the parliament. We will have those words, then we will have the interpretation. Subrule 1, where the party against whom a decree for specific performance of contract or for restitution of conjugal rights or for an injunction has been passed, has had an opportunity of obeying the decree, who? The party against whom the decree is passed. He has had an opportunity of obeying the decree and has willfully failed to obey it. The decree may be enforced in the case of decree for restitution of conjugal rights by the attachment of his property, or in the case of a decree for specific performance of contract or for an injunction, by his detention in civil prison, or by attachment of his property, or by both. So, three types of decree. First, we will deal with the restitution of conjugal rights, because at the end of subrule 1, that is dealt with first. In the case of a decree for restitution of conjugal rights by the attachment of his property, his whose property? Judgment attached. What is a restitution of conjugal rights? You know. Who can be the decree holder? It can be the husband or it can be the wife. How to enforce it? The court cannot direct both parties to be in the same house or in the same room and then come after 1 month and ask whether the restitution was complete. That cannot be done. So, decree for restitution of conjugal rights can be enforced. The word used is enforced by attachment of his property to compel him to obey the decree. That is it. Andhra Pradesh High Court, I do not remember which year, but some years back, 80s or early 90s, held that this provision is unconstitutional. But Supreme Court did not agree with that. That was overruled. Supreme Court said that the provision is legal, constitutional, and a decree for restitution of conjugal rights can be enforced. And in the case of a decree for specific performance of contract, that is a contract for sale of an item of a mole property is there. I am the purchaser, you are the seller. I am prepared to pay the purchase price. But by the time an agreement was executed between us, 6 months period, advance was paid to you, and before the expiry of 6 months, I was ready to pay the money, balance money, but you are not prepared to execute the document in my favor. Why? Because by the time the value of the property has increased considerably. So you are not interested parting with the property. Or you are prepared to execute the document. I am not prepared to accept it by paying the balance amount. Because the value of the property has come down like anything. So if I pay the whole amount as agreed and purchase the property, that will be a very high, huge loss for me. So I am not interested. I keep mum. You want the property to be sold and to execute the document and to receive the balance consideration. I am not prepared. Who can file the suit for specific performance? Either party can file. I am the purchaser. If you are not willing to sell it, I can file a suit for specific performance of the contract and get a decree for directing you to execute the sale deed in my favor after receiving the balance consideration. Or I am not prepared to purchase and pay the balance price and receive the document. You can file a suit to compel me to pay the balance consideration and document will be executed and registered. So the decree holder could be either the plaintiff, the decree, either the seller or buyer. Depends on the circumstance of each case. That is a decree for specific performance of contract. Or for an injunction. Injunction, you know, all these are covered by the specific relief act. What is injunction? It can be prohibitory injunction. It can be mandatory injunction. What is prohibitory injunction? An example, restraining the defendant from entering into the plaintiff's property. Restrain the defendant from cutting trees from my property, plaintiff's property. Restraining the defendant from pulling down the structure, compound wall. See, not to do, not to indulge in such activity which will cause injury to the plaintiff. Permanent, prohibitory, perpetual injunction. Temporary injunction is there. Perpetual, temporary injunction is during the pendency of the suit for a permanent prohibitory injunction as an interlocutory measure, the court may grant temporary injunction. That will expire on the passing of the decree, either decreeing the suit or dismissing the suit, whatever it is. Ad interim injunction, you have seen that expression. That is, I file a suit against you for injunction, permanent prohibitory injunction. You are going to cut the trees. By the time you receive notice, you may cut the whole trees from the property, standing on the property, causing huge loss to me. So I may apply for a temporary injunction, and the court can grant, in the circumstance of the case, court has a discretionary power to grant an ad interim order of injunction and to issue notice, return of notice, after hearing the respondent, that is you, the defendant. The court will pass appropriate orders, either confirm that order or vary, vacate, or any order can be passed. That is ad interim injunction order, interim injunction, temporary injunction, that is the difference. Interim injunction is without hearing the other side, that is urgent, immediate relief. After hearing the other side, the court grants injunction, that is called temporary injunction. And at the end of the, after the trial of the suit, finally disposed of granting injunction, that is permanent prohibitory injunction. What is mandatory injunction? To do certain thing, to compel the defendant to do certain thing. The defendant has pulled down a structure in my compound unauthorizedly by a wanton act, destructive act. I file a suit against the defendant to restore the demolished structure in its original position. Usually what happens in, say, there will be a pathway, somebody wants a vehicular traffic, they may pull down the compound wall under some pretext or other and make a way. So my compound wall is pulled down by you to make it a motorable way. I can file a suit for mandatory injunction to compel you to restore the compound wall to its original position. The court may grant a decree also. How it is to be executed, we'll see. That can be done by attachment. And then there are other methods also in the coming sub-rules. We'll come to that. And for an injunction, by the detention civil prison or by attachment of property. So that is mandatory injunction. While dealing with sub-rule 1, we have slightly deviated and gone to other provisions because I would like to convey to the students what is the meaning of prohibitory injunction, mandatory injunction, what is the difference, where do you find, and all those things. That is why slight deviation has been made. Now we will come to the other, go to the other rule, sub-rules. Sub-rule, 5 sub-rules are there. So if I deal with it and have a lecture, that will not be useful to you. To be useful, we'll have to see the exact words which the legislature has used. Go into it, find out what is the meaning of it. Sub-rule 2. Where the party against whom a decree for specific performance or for an injunction has been passed is a corporation. The decree may be enforced by the attachment of the property of the corporation or with the leave of the court by the detention in civil prison of the directors or the principals officers thereof, or by attachment and detention. That is, if the judgment debtor is a corporation, what is to be done? 3. Where the attachment under sub-rule 1 and 2 has remained in force for 6 months. It was originally 1 year, that has been reduced to 6 months by the 1976 Amendment Act. Now, what is this? Where the attachment under sub-rule 1 or sub-rule 2. Sub-rule 1 covers all the suits, 3 types of suits. Sub-rule 2, that is corporation. Restitution of conjugal rights also. Attachment. Decree for specific performance of contract or injunction. There also attachment is there. So sub-rule 1 covers all the 3 types of decrees. And if the attachment has remained in force for 6 months, if the judgment debtor has not obeyed the decree, and the decree holder has applied to have the attached property sold, such property may be sold, and out of the proceeds the court may award to the decree holder such compensation as it thinks fit, and shall pay the balance, if any, to the judgment debtor on his application. Where the judgment debtor has obeyed the decree and paid all the costs executing the same. Sub-rule 3 itself, it is applied to have the attached property, such property may be sold, and out of the proceeds the court may award to the decree holder such compensation. The executing court may fix the compensation to be paid in the case of a suit for restitution of conjugal rights, or in the case of a specific performance suit, or for injunction. The court may fix a compensation as it thinks fit, and shall pay the balance after sale and realization of that. That is only compensation. Sub-rule 4. Where the judgment debtor has obeyed the decree and paid all the costs of executing the same which is bound to pay. Or where at the end of 6 months from the date of attachment no application has been made, the attachment will cease. Sub-rule 5. Where a decree for specific performance of contract or for injunction not for restitution of conjugal rights, where a decree for specific performance of contract or for an injunction has not been obeyed, the court may, in lieu of, in addition to, all or any of the processes aforesaid. This is in lieu of or in addition to. Direct that the act required to be done may be done. This is very important. Please note the expression. The act required to be done may be done, so far as practicable, by the decree holder or some other person appointed by the court at the cost of the judgmentor, and upon the act being done, the expense incurred may be ascertained in such manner as the court may direct and may be recovered as if they were included in the decree. What is the sub-rule 5? Specific performance of contract or injunction. Require the act required to be done. I am the purchaser as per the contract. You are the seller of an item of immovable property. You are not prepared to execute the sale deed. I file a suit for specific performance. A decree is passed in my favor. I deposit the sale price in court. I am prepared to take the document, but you are not prepared to execute it. What to do? I can apply to the court. Then the document will be executed at the instance of the court. We will come to that later. How it is done? In the name of the judicial officer, it will be done. As if you are the real owner of the property, you have to sell it, but you are not prepared. How to compel you? The document draft will be prepared, that will be approved by the court, and court will appoint some officer, go there to the registrar's office, prepare the document, and the document will show that it is executed by, say, the particular judge, and on his behalf it can be presented for registration before the sub-registrar's office, and the document registered, handed over to me. Then direct that the act required to be done may be done. What is the act required by the defendant to be done? He has to execute and register the sale. That can be done by the court if the defendant, judgmentor, refuses to do it. So that the process is complete, the execution is over, and the decree is satisfied. In spite of your execute, obey the decree, your property can be attached, etc., etc., all those things are there. This is in addition to you or in lieu of, instead of that, you can have this remedy. Or even after that attachment and payment of compensation, you can adopt this. That is why I said that is compensation, not a substitute for the decree. Decree can still be executed. That is a process to compel. Then the document will be executed, registered, and it will be handed over to the decree holder. That process is over. That is specific performance of contract. Otherwise also, suppose the seller is the plaintiff, then also it can be enforced. How? The amount can be realized. If he is not prepared, then compensation also can be claimed. Then there is a rescission of contract and all those things which comes under the Specific Relief Act. Then the court may, in lieu of and in addition to all the process aforesaid, direct that the act required to be done may be done, so far as practicable, by the decree holder or some other person appointed by the court, at the cost of the judgmentor, and upon the act being done, the expense incurred may be ascertained. Here it is, the act required to be done may be, I committed a mistake. The act required to be done may be done by the court. That is specific performance of contract and all those things, documents are there, provisions are there in the Specific Relief Act itself, and also execution can be resorted to. But this is otherwise also. The act required to be done and so far as practicable by the decree holder or some person appointed by the court. See, suppose my compound wall was pulled down by you. I filed a suit for mandatory injunction. Suit was decreed. You are not prepared to restore the compound wall to its original position. I apply to the court. I will say before court, I am prepared to do it. Recover the expenses from him. Then the court may grant permission to me to restore the compound wall to its original position. And the expenses incurred, court may even appoint a commissioner to watch it, to report about it. The court may ascertain the costs incurred, accept my or modify my account, and then fix the amount, and that amount can be recovered from the cost of the judgment debtor, and upon the act being done, expenses incurred may be ascertained in such manner as the court may direct, and may be recovered as if it were included in the decree. It is not included in the decree. Decree is only for mandatory injunction directing the defendant, the judgment debtor, to restore the compound wall of the plaintiff to its original position. But he refuses. The compound wall can be made by me, constructed by the plaintiff, decree holder, and then the expenses incurred can be recovered from the judgment debtor, and the expenses can be ascertained by the court in such manner as it thinks fit, and it may be recovered as if it is included in the decree. Though it is not included in the decree, it is deemed to be included in the decree. Then an explanation was added by the 2002 amendment, that is, for the removal of doubts, it is hereby declared that the expression, the act required to be done, covers prohibitory as well as mandatory injunction. It is a clarificatory amendment. The objects and reasons of the Amendment Act 2002 says that this is a clarificatory amendment. So that the act required to be done covers prohibitory injunction also. We will deal with it in the next episode to some extent. Thank you.